Sup nerds, I'm Cup Joey and welcome back to another episode of Delusional Craigslist. Because you know if people think that they can flog a dead horse, they'll keep flogging it until it stops making money. Let's have a look.
Used coffins for $500.
Yeah, this is totally fine. I mean, it makes sense because, you know, once you're dead, like, why are you going to want your coffin? You know, I just keep mine hanging around, you know, for the current days where I'm alive. As soon as I'm dead, I'm not going to need it anymore, so it makes sense to just shift it on, you know. I'm planning to, you know, come back as a ghost and sell all of my death possessions. So, I mean, just look at the state of them. This looks like, these all hold a curse, okay? These all clearly hold a different curse. As soon as you open them, you're going to be cursed. It's not a good idea. You know, I've seen way too many, like, black and white films on Tutankhamun to know exactly where this is going to be going. You know, it's not going to work out for you, buddy.
Sliding glass door assembly required for just $100. You know, you could have, like, just repurposed this as, like, the trickiest sliding door puzzle ever and, like, got all of the big brain boffins in on it.
Cute car freshies on sale today, $7 each, but normally $9. Oh, and ships for $5. Is this, I mean, surely this isn't purchasable at Chick-fil-A, right? I mean, we don't have it in the UK, but I wouldn't go there anyway because, you know, I'm gay as hell. But, like, no, like, I mean, it looks like it has just been, you know, sellotaped on, like just printed off and then sellotaped. So what is this made out of? It looks like it's freaking rice and then chocolate chips at the top that have been painted. No, this seems cursed. This is all kinds of cursed to me.
Lactating in a tough economy? It's so crazy to me that while things are so difficult, yet everyone is preggo from the pandemic, that it's impossible to find a healthy gal producing more than needed that will spend time with a man. It's so healthy, you can make great money, obviously it's confidential. And you can help improve someone's life. If you are down, I so want to hear from you. I'm a chill, fun, successful, and normal. I am just so attracted to the idea of nursing off a woman. I will be interviewing as well because it has to be a great fit. I'd love a long-term relationship. Compensation to be determined.
You know, I'm so glad that this guy specified that he was normal, because at first I was thinking this seems a little bit abnormal, but then when he said and normal, I was like, oh okay, he's normal, so it's cool.
The main freaking concern about this though is, what was it? Oh yeah, if you are down, I so want to hear from you, like, oh. Oh, so you're deliberately preying upon the ones that are in a bad situation, huh? Oh, dear. And also, that I will be interviewing as well, as it'd be a great fit. It has to be a great fit, and I'd love a long-term relationship. Yes, because all of the best long-term relationships started out with a freaking interview.
Original lighted McDonald's signs, $300 each. McDonald's lighted signs. And then the question, are they stoned? like, no, this is my McDonald's sign from home. Oh, the thing I love about this is, like, why would somebody buy it? Would you be like, you know what, I've always wanted to direct McDonald's customers to my house. Like just for a prank. Just have someone pull up and, like, try and drive through my house. I open the door. Ha! You thought it was McDonald's, but it's me, Joey. Oh, no, that's that freaking JoJo's. Oh, did I meme? I didn't mean to meme. I'm not familiar with the anime, but I just picturing opening the door and there's a car coming in already. I'm just, my brain's going too weird. I'm having too much fun with this one already. I need to move on pretty quick. Finally gave my fingernails the big chop and now I'm selling the clippings. Only $25 to have all these little pieces of me. You should be so lucky. I want someone to purchase these, and upon receiving them, send me a video of you eating them. Who's game? No, I'm not going to accept that this is real. She's trolling. I have to, like, I'm only going to accept that she's trolling. I do not want to live in a world where this is a genuine exchange that's going on the internet. And that she would just happily put her face next to it. I'm not going to accept that as my reality. I substitute your reality for my own. She's having a laugh, and I'm laughing along with her. It's a good joke. Okay, let's move on.
iPhone 11 Pro Max read description imported, $900. It's an iPhone 11 Pro Max, but it's Android. I bought it for $1,200, and I found out later I got scammed. So someone would be generous enough to switch it with another iPhone 11 Pro Max. God bless you. Yep, that's right. I got scammed, and so I was wondering if you could help me by getting scammed too. I'll just keep the freaking Android phone. Android's better than Apple anyway. I was never really on a side in the debate. I never really cared. I had like a freaking, like, not even a smartphone for ages. I was using the old WAP back in like 2013 still. So that should tell you all about the technology that I use. I even remember like going on my phone to check something on the internet and my friend next to me going, "Oh my God, is that WAP?" And I was like, "Oh, thanks." you know, because she was somebody that did computer science and she was interested and was talking about old tech, and I just felt so poor. The joys of being a freaking poor student in a university where like the vast majority went to private school, it's just absolute hell. Rare McDonald's Playland window, $195. Vintage, good condition. This is something the other kids won't have. I wonder why. Because, you know, your kids really want to boast, hey, you know what I've got? I've got a freaking McDonald's Playland window. Yeah, I can sit with this and pretend that I'm playing at McDonald's. You can't do that, can you? $195, though. I mean, scrap value alone, that's definitely not worth that much. From McDonald's, are you kidding? I mean, what is it with this trend of, like, selling random parts from McDonald's, like from the freaking buildings? Like, this is just what I'm not understanding. The only one that I liked was like the one where it was like all the burgers on the back of the chair. That looked pretty cool, and I would have that on my chair because, you know, that is fun. But like lights or a Playland window, and just people are gonna want this, like, no matter how you, oh, I can dress it up as an interesting piece. No, you can't, no. Snickers entire bite-sized collector set, $45. Rare collection of all letters spelling Snickers, including the elusive C and K. Serious inquiries only, please. You know, I wasn't that bothered until they said that they even had the elusive C and K, and now I know I definitely want them. But the only, like, problem is that, I know what they've done here. They have got two of the beginning S. You can't convince me. You can't convince me. Two different S's. You just put the beginning S twice. You see, if you turn it around, you can see it's exactly the same S. It's terrible. Chick-fil-A on a Sunday, $12. Spicy chicken sandwich for those who are craving it on the day it's closed. No fries or drink included. I have about 7 left. Message me for details. I hate Chick-fil-A. I mean, I've never had it, but I hate homophobia, so I hate Chick-fil-A. But one thing that I have to say about this is, why would you want something the next day after it's gone all cold and soggy and greasy and dank, and you've not got that, like, crunchy, ooh, yummy that you get with these, like, fried chickeny things? Why would you go, oh yeah, I really want it the next day, freaking dank, at least you got 7 of them. I wonder, come on, why have you got 7 left? Have people shown interest before? No. No fries or drink included, freaking heartbroken. 4 thick toilet rolls swap for a Nintendo Switch. I don't think we're even running out of bog roll anymore anyway, but even if we are, that's freaking gross to try and get people to give you, like you're just trying too hard, but it's rude as well. It's just an awful thing to do. You know, nobody wants your freaking toilet paper, and nobody's gonna give away a Switch for it. Trust me, people are locked down, they're gonna want their freaking Switches. Custom made and painted TV stands. Needs a little cleaning and to be finished. Otherwise, it's not even finished. But we decided to sell it. Need God, no space. Service Alco is 100 firm. Serious buyers only.
It doesn't surprise me that somebody that was doing a project to do with the Confederate flag just, you know, gave up. Sounds about right. Also, like, just a tiny freaking point, one of the things that really made me laugh is how in the bottom picture, just underneath, you can see that they've got a Hotel Transylvania DVD with just freaking Dracula just grinning up over there. It's like he's trolling the whole post. I just love that. Free ketchup and hot sauce packets. Make great Halloween treats as well as stocking stuffers for Christmas. Enjoy. Ah, yes, because all the kids, when they want a little treat, little treat for Halloween, they really want their freaking Kraft mayonnaise. Oh no, the one for kids is obviously the Hello Kitty soy sauce. Freaking wasabi! Wasabi for kids. Stocking stuffers. Oh no, just like freaking opening the Diablo hot sauce. Just open up your freaking stocking on Christmas Day and you see nothing except for Live Mass at the bottom. Vintage Happy Halloween blank greeting card, NHK West Studios. Oh, for just $50, that's a steal. That's an absolute steal. Like, this isn't something that anybody could recreate for, like, less than that. And what OP said about this, which made me enjoy it even more, is that all it says in the description is, yes. So there you have it. I'm just, like, gonna go ahead and freaking Google NHK West Studios to see if that's actually a thing. Okay, so I googled NHK West Studios, and the only thing that I can get is the Japanese media group, the NHK Broadcasting Center, which I was actually aware of, because they do, you know, if you are international and you want Japanese news, say, then they have, a station that they broadcast in the UK, so I have heard of them before, but it's not NHK West, it's NHK Broadcasting Center, and yeah, it's not a thing. It's not a thing. I don't know whether they were trying to genuinely convince somebody that this was a vintage thing or whether it was just for the lulz. I like to think it was the latter. Well, actually, I'd like to think it was the former, but I think it actually is the latter.
Very cool acorn for $100. Posted 1 hour ago in Antiques. Ooh, even it's new. It has never been used. So thank God, you wouldn't want a second-hand used acorn. No, I want that stuff to be pristine before I go near it. Oh, what I love about this is the fact that they're, like, very cool. it's like when people are desperate for money and then they're going around, like, trying to, you know, force it on you. My dad said that, like, back in the, like, it was before I was born, I reckon, so it would have been, like, in the late 80s, there was this guy that used to go around all of these pubs with this freaking boombox under his arm that was broken and was trying to sell it for, like, 20 quid, or 50 quid even. And, like, he always had it. He was always trying to sell it, and it just never freaking worked, and this gave me that vibe, but, you know, at least then it was a freaking boombox and not just a random acorn. You know, looking across these adverts, one of these things doesn't seem like the others. That's right, there's a Samsung Galaxy in between all of the Apple iPhones. Selling my Beanie Baby collection, they're currently all suffocating in bags. I have, like, tucks and crap. $10,000 or best offer. Things are about to get weird. Oh my god. Yes. Oh yes, this is how you go about selling your Beanie Baby collection. Oh my god, that's just so beautiful. Although from all I can see here, there's just like the Princess Bear and and the platypus. What I've noticed, though, is, like, not in the main picture, but in, like, the second one down where he's got the cross eyes and the thing, he really looks like, Lalo Salamanca from Better Call Saul. I've been watching that recently. It's really good. They're currently all suffocating in bags. That was what made it for me. I got reminded of when I was at this car boot sale, and at a lot of them you'll find people that are selling a lot of different toys, you know. I actually mostly go there for the toys. I'm a freaking child, I'm a giant baby. But once there was this little kid walking along, and he had this, like,
like maybe like a doll, like a, you know, one of the doll baby dolls things that the kids play with, you know, like I forget what they're called, baby no tears or whatever. I genuinely forgot like the words for them, but whatever. And anyway, he was carrying along this baby and it was in a bag. Like, the thing is that because he was very small, this kid was holding it under his arm, like the arm was around the neck, so it was like this bag tightened around this toy doll's neck, like, all new from Mattel, baby can't breathe. Just, oh, for God's sake. I just, this made me think of that, and I love it, I love it. I really do. And then he's just not taking it any seriously. Things are about to get weird. I think they already have, my friend. Zizza scene, no title, no check engine light on, good mother. I wanted one of these so bad when I was a kid. I don't know about everyone else, but for me, like, this was just, like, the ultimate, yes, I can go down the freaking M24 in this thing. I mean, the only way that I would buy this is if I know that it's past its MOT. You might have seen on my page that I now have a Patreon. So for just £2, you will get exclusive access to my blooper reel with unseen bits that I haven't yet posted on this channel. And at the highest tier, you will get your name in credits at the end of my videos. Bearing in mind that I post a video 5 times a week, that's a lot of videos you're gonna get your name in credits on. If not, a little like and a subscribe on my channel help a lot. Well, that's it for this episode of r/delusionalcraigslist. Honestly, there is no limit to the amount of weird goods and services that people are willing to buy and sell on places like Facebook Marketplace. And as I say at the end of every episode, if you enjoyed hearing from this subreddit or would like to hear from any other subreddit, then do let me know in the comments. Similarly, if there's anything else you'd like me to investigate, just let me know. And until then, I'll see you all next time.